Good morning students. Today, as you know that we are doing chapter 8, how do organisms reproduce? This is the last part of this chapter. Previously, you have studied modes of asexual reproduction and sexual reproduction. As you know, in last class, we studied that sexual reproduction has two stages. In first stage, formation of gametes, formation of reproductive cells takes place. And reproductive cells are haploid in nature, you know, we explained in last class. And there are two kinds of cells, somatic cells and reproductive cells. So somatic cells are diploid and those are converted into haploid reproductive cells. You studied and you studied that after that, that reproductive cell further divides to form two copies. First, DNA copy take place, replication of DNA takes place, and then two cells are made, two reproductive cells are made. So this was the basic of reproduction in various sexual reproduction. And you know that after formation of gametes, male and female gamete fuse together to form zygote, and zygote divides to form embryo, and embryo changes develops into child. जैसा कि आपने last class में flowering plants में पढ़ा था. That pollen grains, which are male gametes in flowers, fuses with egg in ovaries and they fuse together to form zygote, which changes into seed. So, similar process in human beings. So, as you know, the sperms are the gametes in males and egg is the gamete in female. So, you know how they are produced, how these haploid reproductive cells are produced, but do you know that where are they produced and at which stage they are produced? सो यू नो दैट इनिशियली जब हम छोटे होते हैं तब हमारी बॉडी ग्रोथ ज़्यादा होती है. इनिशियली आवर ग्रोथ जो होती है दैट इज़ ऑन एनलार्जमेंट ऑफ आवर बॉडी, हमारे हाथ पैर बॉडी की ग्रोथ होती है. बट एट ए पार्टिकुलर स्टेज आवर बॉडी ग्रोथ स्लोज डाउन, क्योंकि एक स्टेज आती है जब हमारी बॉडी ग्रोथ कम हो जाती है. लेकिन जो हमारे रिप्रोडक्टिव सेल ऑर्गन्स हैं, द ग्रोथ ऑफ रिप्रोडक्टिव ऑर्गन्स इंक्रीजेस एंड एट दिस स्टेज hormones are released. As you know that in males, testis is an endocrine gland which releases hormones, and those hormones are responsible for formation of sperms as well as appearance of secondary sexual characters. And in females, reproductive gland is ovary, and ovary secretes those hormones like estrogen that is responsible for formation of egg and appearance of secondary sexual characters. So you should study, must study this from your NCERT book, that the body of the individual organism is growing to its adult size, then mainly directed at achieving the growth. Okay, but at a stage rate of general body growth begins to slow, but reproductive tissues begin to mature. This period during adolescence, during teenage, is known as puberty. So at this stage, at puberty, when our body growth slows down but reproductive tissues growth begins to mature, our hormones begins to release, then at this stage hormones responsible for sexual characters and formation of gametes start to release. That stage is puberty. So puberty is that stage of adolescence at which reproductive tissues begin to mature. So what are different changes during puberty? Puberty occurs at generally 13-14 years of age, and it might vary slightly from individual to individual. But what happens in puberty? You know, puberty, our reproductive organs, which are testes and ovaries, begin to grow. And so they begin releasing gametes, and also secondary sexual characters appears. As you know, in boys, hair growth takes place on faces and voice becomes harsh. And you can read this from your book. Some changes are common in boys and girls. Hair growth in armpits and genital areas. skin becomes oily and development of pimples. And there are various changes given in this book. You can read from your book. So when puberty comes, these characters appear and they begin to release hormones and which are responsible for formation of gametes. So you can study actual transfer of germ cells between two people need special organs for the sexual act. So humans have reproductive organs for fertilization. The process of fertilization for reproduction, they have specific reproductive organs. So we will proceed with the reproductive systems in males and females. So this is the male reproductive system, as you can see. So the most important part is testis. Here, this is the testis. You know, testis is placed inside scrotum. So there is scrotum. And inside scrotum is like a pouch, and inside this scrotum two testes are present. Testes are the glands, organs which are present inside scrotum, and this scrotum is outside the body. They are located outside the abdominal cavity because sperm formation of gametes requires lower temperature. Low hona chahiye sperm formation ke liye. That's why jo testes hoti hai वो बॉडी के आउटसाइड प्रेजेंट होती हैं. ओके, एंड यू नो द फंक्शन ऑफ टेस्टिस. टेस्टिस के फंक्शंस आप यू हैव स्टडीड. द टेस्टिस रिलीज हार्मोन टेस्टोस्टेरोन, एंड दिस हार्मोन इज रिस्पॉन्सिबल फॉर फॉर्मेशन ऑफ गैमेट्स, स्पर्म्स एंड सेक्सुअल कैरेक्टर्स. ओके, सो व्हेन स्पर्म्स आर फॉर्म्ड, they are passed to the penis through this a tube which is known as vas deferens. You can read this vas deferens. It is like a tube which passes the sperms from testis to penis. This is the vas deferens, you can see. Or between this path, is raste ke beech mein, there are two glands. One is prostate gland. Okay, prostate gland, and there are seminal vesicle. You can see prostate gland and seminal vesicle. So in this path, when sperms move through vas deferens, prostate gland and seminal vesicle also release their secretions. They release, seminal vesicle and prostate gland release some fluids, okay, which give nutrition to the sperms. You can study this, that along the path of vas deferens, glands like the prostate and the seminal vesicles add their secretions so that sperms are now in a fluid which makes their transport easier. Transport of sperms become easier, and fluids also provides nutrition. Sperms are tiny bodies that consists of mainly genetic material and a long tail that helps them to move towards the female germ cells. Okay, genetic material means information, DNA, those all things. Genetic is formed from gene, and gene is a unit of DNA. Okay, so this is the male reproductive system. The sperm formed are delivered through the vas deferens, okay, and which unites with urinary bladder. This bladder is urinary bladder where urine is stored, and you know, at some point, the path of urine and sperm is same through vas deferens. You can study that sperm soma delivered through the vas deferens, which unites with a tube coming from urinary bladder. The urethra thus becomes a common passage for both sperms and urine. You have understood the different glands, different organs in male reproductive system and their functions, and how sperms are formed, where sperms are formed, and how they are passed to the urethra. So next is female reproductive system. As you know, this is sexual mode of reproduction, requires two individuals, male and female. So what is female reproductive system? लाइक इन मेल्स टेस्टिस वाज द रिप्रोडक्टिव टिश्यू रिप्रोडक्टिव ऑर्गन एंड इन मेल इन फीमेल्स ओवेरी इज द रिप्रोडक्टिव ग्लैंड. देर आर टू ओवेरीज इन फीमेल रिप्रोडक्टिव सिस्टम. ओके एंड ओवेरी का फंक्शन सिमिलर टू टेस्टिस दैट ओवेरी रिलीजेज फीमेल गैमेट्स विच आर एग्स एंड दीज एग्स आर रिलीज्ड बाय ओवेरीज. ओके व्हेन दीज एग्स आर रिलीज्ड बाय ओवेरीज दे पास्ड टू फेलोपियन ट्यूब. दिस इज द फेलोपियन ट्यूब. यू कैन सी एज इन मेल रिप्रोडक्टिव सिस्टम देर वॉज वास्ट डिफरेंस फॉर ट्रांसफर ऑफ स्पर्म्स. सिमिलरली इन फीमेल्स फेलोपियन ट्यूब और ओविडक्ट सेम थिंग. ओविडक्ट और फेलोपियन ट्यूब इज द पैसेज फॉर एग. ओके इन दिस फेलोपियन ट्यूब मेल स्पर्म्स एंड फीमेल एग्स फ्यूज टूगेदर एंड फर्टिलाइज. सो फर्टिलाइजेशन टेक्स प्लेस इन साइड फेलोपियन ट्यूब. ओके एंड द फर्टिलाइज एग देन एंटर्स टू इन टू यूटेरस. दिस इज द यूटेरस एंड इन साइड यूटेरस ग्रोथ ऑफ फर्टिलाइज एग टेक्स प्लेस विच फॉर्म्स zygote एंड zygote चेंजेस इंटू एम्ब्रियो एंड एम्ब्रियो इंटू चाइल्ड. यू शुड नो दैट एवरी मंथ वन ऑफ द ओवेरी रिलीजेस वन एग इन मैच्योर्ड फीमेल. वन ओवेरी रिलीजेस वन एग पर मंथ एंड these egg fertilize with sperms. Sperms enter through vagina and in fallopian tube. They fuse with the egg. So when a girl is born, ovaries contain thousands of eggs. But on reaching puberty, one egg is produced every month by one of the ovaries. The egg is carried from the ovary to the womb or uterus by oviduct or fallopian tube. Okay. The sperms enter through the vaginal passage during sexual intercourse. They travel upwards and reach fallopian tube where they may encounter the egg. Then fertilized egg, zygote, gets implanted in the lining of the uterus. And starts dividing because when it divides, zygote changes into embryo. So that's how fertilization in human beings takes place. So now what happens when the zygote is implanted inside uterus? Jab uterus mein zygote implant ho jata hai, what happens? So the uterus prepares itself every month to receive and nurture growing embryo. Every month uterus lining thickens, जो यूटेरस की लाइनिंग होती है वो थिक हो जाती है टू रिसीव द एम्ब्रियो एंड इज रिचली सप्लाइड विद द ब्लड टू न्यूरिश द ग्रोइंग एम्ब्रियो. सो व्हेन फर्टिलाइजेशन टेक्स प्लेस एंड zygote implants into uterus, then uterus lining thickens and is richly supplied with blood to nourish the growing embryo. Okay, but in case fertilization does not take place, what happens? You know, uterus every month prepares and becomes thick and spongy by blood vessels. Okay, but in case fertilization does not take place, जो lining, जो thick lining blood vessels की बनी है इसकी ज़रूरत अब नहीं है because कोई embryo, कोई zygote अब enter नहीं कर रहा है. So, the lining slowly breaks and comes out through vagina as blood and mucus. And this cycle takes place every month because every month one egg is released by ovaries and uterus prepares itself, becomes thick. So this cycle takes place every month and it lasts for 2 to 8 days. And this process is known as menstruation. And you have menstruation, you have also studied in class 8. Now you are again studying this, that when uterus starts bleeding, the blood vessels in uterus starts become to break, the blood comes out through vagina due to no fertilization takes place. So this is menstruation. In Since the ovary releases one egg every month, uterus also prepares itself every month to receive fertilized egg. It becomes thick and spongy to nourish the embryo. But if fertilization does not take place, lining becomes breaks and blood comes out. But if fertilization takes place and embryo gets implanted in uterus, what happens? See, the embryo gets nutrition from mother's blood with the help of special tissues called placenta. What is placenta? It is a disc which is embedded in uterine wall. जो uterus की wall होती है उसके अंदर placenta एक tissue होता है, and through placenta, through this tissue, the embryo gets nutrition from mother's blood. जैसा कि आपने digestive system में पढ़ा था, there are some structures villi, and villi were responsible for absorption of food and transferring it to blood. Similarly, placenta में भी villis होती हैं. It contains villi on embryo side of tissue, and on mother sides are blood vessels which surround the villi. Okay, same thing. This provide a large surface area and to pass from mother to embryo. Okay, so one function of placenta is providing nutrition to the baby embryo. Another function is that the developing embryo will also generate waste substances. जो embryo will also generate waste, and that can be removed by transferring into mother's blood. जैसे कि mother's blood से food embryo में enter हो रहा है through villi, through blood vessels. Similarly, waste substances are removed from embryo to mother's blood through placenta. So placenta has two functions. The development of the child inside mother's body takes place about 9 months. And the child is born as a result of rhythmic contractions of muscles in the uterus. So this is the structure of placenta. You can see this is a uterine wall, uterus wall, and inside uterus wall there is placenta. The baby is inside a tissue which is known as placenta, and the baby is attached to the placenta by umbilical cord. And you know that on the baby side of placenta, embryo side of placenta, there are villis, and on the other side there are blood vessels. So the baby is getting nutrition from mother's blood, and the important nutrients are absorbed by blood vessels and they are passed through villi to the embryo. Similarly, the waste substances are also removed from placenta to the through the villi to the mother's blood. So you studied about reproductive organs in males and females. Now we will study a very important topic, that is reproductive health. Reproductive health. So you know that you have studied that infection, diseases can transmit from one person to another. Okay, and when there is sexual contact, there is high probability of transmitting of diseases. So there are some diseases which occur due to the sexual acts, which are HIV AIDS. One is, you can see here, gonorrhea, syphilis, and very dangerous disease HIV AIDS. So these diseases are due to sexual contacts between two persons. So these are the health threats in reproduction. Also, reproduction causes pregnancy, and it is not necessary that girl's body and mind is ready for pregnancy. So we need to take care of two things: prevention of diseases and prevention of pregnancy. So how can the sexually transmitted diseases can be prevented? It is possible to prevent the transmission of such diseases by using a condom to prevent transmission of these infections. Okay, and to avoid pregnancy, there are also many methods. One of these is condoms, which is a physical method. Another is contraceptive method. In contraceptive method, some pills are given and it bring change into hormones. Contraceptive acts by changing the hormonal balance of the body so that eggs are not released. Or egg release nahi honge to fertilization nahi hoga, pregnancy nahi hogi. So oral pills jo eye pills hoti hain, that prevent the releasing of eggs by ovaries. Other contraceptive devices are loop or copper T. Copper T is placed inside uterus to prevent pregnancy. Also, they have some side effects. There are some surgical methods, as you know that in males there is a passage which is vas deferens, and in female the passage is fallopian tube. If these passages are blocked, then transfer will be prevented. So if the vas deferens in the male is blocked, sperm transfer will be prevented. If fallopian tube in the female is blocked, egg will not be able to reach the uterus. In both cases, fertilization will not take place. So you studied about three methods. One is barrier method using of condoms and copper T, hormonal methods such as use of contraceptive pills, hormonal chemical methods, and barrier methods. There is another device used which is IUD, which is known as intrauterine contraceptive device, which is placed inside uterus. So there are various methods, surgical methods which include the cutting of, surgery of vas deferens in males and fallopian tube in females. So this includes surgical methods. So there are three kinds of methods to avoid pregnancy. So you must read this from your NCERT book and make some notes, then you can understand this very well. Thank you and have a nice day.